God had an idea. It was not a new idea. He had always had this idea, right from when he created the world. It was his own special idea. It was in his heart. It was part of him. This was God's idea, to go and be with the people he had created on earth. It would be like sending light into a dark place. It would have to be a special light after all. It would be God on earth, God with people. God's idea was a good one. It was an idea full of love. By sending himself to be with people, he would be giving new life to the earth, new life to all people, a special kind of God life. But how would God do that? God had already appeared to people over hundreds of years in many different ways, in a burning bush, as a great wind, as a still quiet voice whispering in your ear, even as handwriting on a wall. But this was to be different. This was to be God living on earth. This was a big idea. God's big idea needed something special. Special but small. A baby. That's how God would show himself to people. A baby. But not any baby. This would be God's son. Created by his Holy Spirit. Born of God. And those who saw the baby and loved him, they would see God. They would know that God was with them. They would know that God loved them. For many years, God told people about his idea. He told his prophets and his priests and the kings and the ordinary people. He told them that one day he would send his special person to be with them. He gave them lots of clues, like you do when there is an exciting surprise ahead. The people wrote them down, but they didn't really understand them. And after a while, they got tired of waiting and wondered if perhaps God had forgotten about his good idea. And then, when it was just the right time, the perfect moment, God spoke.
Soon, very soon, I will send a special person into the world. Everyone, get ready. He will be like a light for the world. Not the kind of light that comes from a lamp or a torch, but the kind of light that shines out bright, happy faces. An inside light. A special light.
And so God reached out to human beings. He sent himself to live an ordinary life with an ordinary family. His own son, a little boy. Sent to the world that God himself had made. The same spirit of creation who had hung the stars in the sky and made the mountains high and rivers wet. That spirit was made into a little baby, a little boy, born to an ordinary mum and ordinary dad, but also the son of God. Only thing was, the people were thinking about other things. They were busy making money, fighting wars, and cleaning houses, and playing in the streets. And those who did remember what God had promised, well, they were looking in other places. They thought the clues meant something else, and they certainly weren't looking for a baby. How ordinary, they thought. Just one of us. He can't be God's good idea, they thought. Not a baby. A baby who wasn't even a rich prince. They didn't expect God to want to be with humans, so they didn't even notice his coming. They turned away from God's good idea. They carried on as if nothing had happened. But not everyone did. Some people looked at the baby and the man that the baby grew into, and they saw the godness in him. Those people listened when he taught them about God and his love for people, and they understood a little more about God. They saw that here was a way of being with God on earth, and they called him Immanuel, which means God with us, even though his parents had called him Jesus.